a beautiful Sufi meditation technique to heal the wounds of your Sahasrara. Your mind, your Sahasrara is filled with wounds. You close your eyes, you remember only the people who disturbed you, haunted you, abused you. Man who gave money and asking you continuously. And man who took money and not returning back. Whenever somebody asks money from us also, we feel disturbed. Whenever somebody took money and not giving back also, we feel disturbed. Your mind is filled with only these memories. With these memories. Never let these memories work on you. Let your Sahasrara be healed by remembering or feeling the people who are reason for your joy, ecstasy, wealth, health, happiness and everything. It's a great Sufi meditation technique to heal the Sahasrara, to open the crown center. In your life, whenever you feel grateful, you will see the bliss overflows. The world also reflects the bliss. Whenever you are violent, the world also reflects the violence. There is a beautiful Quran saying, world and master, enlightened person and the world, both are like a mirror. If you look at the world, you will see only your image. If a donkey goes and stands in front of the mirror, what it will see? What it will see? If you say world is very bad, you are just seeing your mirror, your image. Krishna once called Dharma Duryodhana and told Dharma, go and find out at least one bad person from the world. He told Duryodhana, please go and find out at least one good person. Both of them came back empty-handed. Both came back empty-handed. Dharma said, in everybody there is something good. How can I say somebody is bad, Krishna, bad Bhagavan? Duryodhana said, in everybody I find something bad, Krishna. How can I say somebody is good? Master is also a mirror. If you find joy in him, you are seeing your image. It is your image which is reflected. When you can see joy in Master, why not joy in the world also? I have seen so many people. They have beautiful, loving, great devotion for me. They have so much of respect for me. But they don't respect others. They don't respect fellow devotees. That's a very big problem I am facing. That only creates politics. They have so much respect for me, but they don't respect others. Because respecting me is very easy. I am going to be there only with 2-3 days with them.
Eternal respect.
No, I am going to be there only 2-3 days. And moreover, I don't interfere in their life. I am always giving, sharing. So there is easy to show respect for me. But only when you show respect to your fellow devotees, you really grow. When you see Nityananda in them, you see really me. Something, Asmita, question?
I was just thinking, if we have to respect each and everybody, doesn't it come from inside? Unless you respect yourself, I don't see it happening.
Two things. If you respect yourself, you respect others.
Yes.
If you respect others, you respect yourself.
Yeah, inside out or outside in?
Experience or expression, expression or experience. Any one thing. If you catch any one thing, you will reach the other thing. It's nice you have some real thinking. That's why you are able to ask some other questions. Don't think people who don't ask questions, you understood everything. There are many people who are sitting here. I know everything, why should I ask? And no, most of us, we think, I know, I understood everything. That is why I don't need to ask anything. When you really see God in everyone, respect everyone, only then you feel grateful for the life and you really feel the joy or ecstasy of life. Now, take few moments to give your gratitude to everyone whomsoever has come into your life, either you think they help you or you think they disturb you. We will remember one by one, inch by inch, to give our heartfelt gratitude to all of them. If they help you, they help you. If they disturb you, they have solidified you. They have made you more strengthened. Please have the flowers. Have the flowers in your hand. Offer your gratitude to every one of them. And finally, you will be offering that flowers in front of a carpet. There will be a carpet. On that carpet, you can offer. Offering it to the divine or to the existence.